getting really cold outside these days. Let's make my four favorite winter cocktails. Now that winter has come, it's time to cozy up with a warming cocktail in our hand. I personally don't enjoy winter very much, and one of the things that gets me through it is the pleasure to enjoy seasonal taste. Today, I'm gonna share my four favorite winter cocktails of the moment. There's gonna be gin, rum, bourbon, and even a warm cocktail for the first time on the channel. I hope you will enjoy this. Let's go make some drinks. First, let's make the Earl Grey MarTEAni. We need to start with infusing some gin with Earl Grey tea. It only takes 10 minutes and it's easy as dropping a bag of Earl Grey tea in 4 ounces of gin. Like that, you get enough to make 2 cocktails and you can scale that up as you need. In your shaker, start with 2 ounces of your Earl Grey infused gin. I use Tanqueray. 3/4 ounce of lemon juice, freshly squeezed. 1/2 ounce of rich syrup. And an egg white. First, give it a dry shake for 20-30 seconds without ice. Then add some ice in your shaker. Give it a good shake for 10 seconds. Serve it in your glass of choice. I just love the foamy texture that the egg white gives to the drink. I add no garnish to this one. I think the foam is beautiful enough. Now, this really is my kind of iced tea. It's basically a gin sour, but enhanced with the floral and citrusy notes from the Earl Grey tea. Minimal effort for a big result on flavors. If you haven't tried this one, don't wait any longer. Next, let's make my gingerbread old fashioned. For this one, we start by making a very quick and simple gingerbread syrup. It's basically a classic rich syrup with 2 parts brown sugar to 1 part hot water, with the addition of your favorite winter spices. Think ginger, cinnamon, cloves, star anise, allspice. Simply let it infuse for 30 minutes, strain it, and you're ready to go. In your mixing glass, start with 1.5 ounce of bourbon. I'm using Wild Turkey 101. 1/2 ounce of Amaro. I'm using Ramazzotti. You can try this one with any Amaro you like. 1/4 ounce of our gingerbread syrup, 3 dashes Angostura, and 1 dash orange bitters. Fill your mixing glass with ice, give it a good mix until chilled and diluted, and serve it over a big block of ice. With this one, you get your classic old-fashioned vibe with rich notes of classic baking spices. Added depth from the Amaro, definitely a cozy winter drink in my book. Now let's make the Freetown, one of my favorite recent discoveries. In a mixing glass, start with 2 ounces of dark rum, 1 ounce of red port. The recipe calls for tawny port, just use the best quality red port you can find. 1/2 ounce of simple syrup, and 2 dashes of Peychaud's bitter. Fill your mixing glass with ice, give it a good mix for 20-30 seconds. And serve it in your favorite coupe. For garnish, I use 3 maraschino cherries. So this one is essentially a Rhum and Port Manhattan. I think the deep and complex flavors of the port are complementing the rum absolutely well. This is extremely rich and comforting. A lot is going on in the glass. A nice discovery and a great after-dinner sipper. Finally, let's make a hot cocktail. This one is called the Jasmin Abbey Toddy. In a heat-proof glass, start with 1.5 ounce of Benedictine. Next, add 1/2 ounce of high proof bourbon, 1/2 ounce of freshly squeezed lemon juice, 1/4 ounce of honey syrup, and 3 dashes of Angostura bitter. Finally, top with piping hot jasmine tea. For garnish, I simply drop a star anise on the drink. So as a toddy should be, this drink is warming, sweet, and boozy. The honey and spice notes from the Benedictine are definitely shining bright and matching perfectly with the floral notes from the jasmine tea. This is a very satisfying cocktail. So there you have four cozy winter cocktails. I hope this will help keeping you warm during the cold season. Thank you very much for watching today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't. I will see you soon for more cocktail adventures. Cheers.